Hello learners, in this lecture we will see how the finishing of a concrete surface has to be done. So the finishing of a concrete surface is going to happen when we are going to do the three different operations. The first operation is called as creading. Once the creading is done, we need to do the floating of the surface, and once the floating is done, we are going to go for the traveling of that. So how it is to be done, we'll try to see there. So this operation is called as creading. So you can see it here, right? Once the concrete has been placed, once you've done the vibration and all, so then what we are going to do, we are going to deploy one or two masons, and then he is going to do a level surface, something like this. So with the help of aluminium rod, he is going to do this kind of activity. So this is called as screeding. So the next one what we have is the floating. So in the floating, we'll try to make use of this equipment type. With the help of this, we are going to do the floating of this, right? So again, you're going to get the very clean surface at the top. Along with that, we'll try to make use of one more instrument. We'll try to see that as well. And the final is a traveling. So this is how it is done. Once all the surface is leveled, then we'll try to make use of this instrument, and after this what will happen, the proper surface you're going to get. So we'll try to see this in a bit detail now. So the first is the screeding activity. We can see it here, right? The leveling operation that removes the humps and hollows and gives a true uniform concrete surface is called as screeding, or the process of removing the excess quantity of the concrete to bring the top surface to the proper level is called as screeding. You can see these people are doing the screeding. And now what has happened here? Here the concrete surface is not uniform, right? And also there is some excess quantity of concrete here. Now they will try to run this. So with the help of this, what will happen? Everything you can see here, you're going to get a level surface, something like this, right? Yeah. So next is called as floating. So in the previous slide also, we had seen a floating, where they were using a small horizontal plate, and over that there is a stick attached to that. That is also called as floating. But if you go for the construction of the road, and also the especially for the industrial plant and all, when we are going to put the flooring, this is a kind of a floating that we try to use. So the process of removing the irregularities from the surface of the concrete left after the screeding is called as floating. This helps in leveling the surface and compacting the concrete. The floating is done with the help of a wooden float, as we saw in the previous lecture, and as we saw in the previous slide. The wooden float is 30 centimeter to 45 centimeter long and 20 centimeter wide. Along with that, as I mentioned, if you're going for some industrial buildings and all, in that case, they try to make use of this machine, and this operation, what they're doing is also called as floating. And the last one, what we have is a traveling activity. That we already seen in the previous slide also. So the final operation of finishing is called as traveling. It is performed where a smooth and a dense concrete surface is desired. Traveling is performed while concreting, where the concrete is too soft and the plastic. You can see it here, no? So once your floating is done, you try to run this traveling machine over that. So as a result of that, you are going to get a very good surface. Okay. So this again, usually it is done in the pavement construction, and also in the industrial structure. So normal concrete, if you're doing a slab work and all, in that case, we don't go with the traveling activity, right? So this is specially done where actually you want a very good surface, a very good shiny surface, so that you can make use of the travel and do this activity, right? So this was all about the finishing activity. We had a screeding, we have floating, and we have a traveling option. So in the next lecture, we'll try to see what is curing, how it has to be done and all. So far we have covered all the process of concrete, that is how a concrete is manufactured, how it is placed, how it is transported, how the finishing is to be done. And after this, we'll try to see how to do the curing and what are the different types of curing and all. So we'll see you back in the next lecture. Thank you.